Yo guys, what is up? My name is Easy Taps, and today we are back and we are going to be talking about a topic that I just seen on TikTok. Now, I believe it was a week ago, China had made the very first flight of a flying car that is going to be announced to everybody in the world, I believe only in China for right now, in 2023. And this TikToker was talking about, hey, you know, this is going to get rid of vehicle accidents, you know, crashing, you know, and a lot of things else. But you have to think about it. A flying car. If you go and look at the video of the China releasing this flying car, you know, there was a lot of things that could go wrong with this product here. First of all, we could wait until more technology gets more advanced to do this, because right now we're trying to see if we can get the Mars, and you know that's not here yet. So China, you know, they have robots, well technically we can call them robots, you know, working hotels and a lot of things else. We don't have that in America. We probably have some, but not a lot as China. And China does is kind of a little bit more advanced than us in a way because of having robots and a lot of things else. But, you know, America, you know, we also advance. But, like, if it had to come down between each other, I believe China would probably win between with the robots and a lot of things else. And because, you know, you don't see us, you know, going to doing robotic ideas. I mean, some, but not a lot. Known as NASA, we are trying to see if we can get to Mars. And then we have SpaceX, known as we have Elon Musk helping within there. We have, like, a lot of things happening. So, the flying car thing with you. Let's go back to that. So, the test first flight showed off, and it was a complete success. Now, I may be wrong about this in 2023, but if we're talking about car casualties, oh, I'm saying that wrong, but accidents, car accidents and us crashing in between another, I think this is a really bad idea for China, at least because of, you gotta think, if we are having pollution in the air and we're having winds that, you know, we're having winds that can blow rain and everything, you know, we have waterproof phones that can go to a certain depth, I should say. So, if we're talking about a flying car in 2023, coming up and flying and testing off. Now, first thing, you would have to worry about wind. Is it going to be more windy today? Because you don't want the car to be flying off. And, you know, what could happen is the wind could push you back. You know, and the car would flip and, you know, you would be crashing into the ground. Boom, you're dead, like, right off the bat. And you have to worry about a lot of things else known as buildings, power lines. You would probably have to have a decent license of driving it. You would be flying it, most likely. So, pretty much, they would have a new license, maybe. I don't know how it goes in China. But, a new license, there you go, for that. And second of all, you have to worry about landing. If you need to get gas or something else, you need to worry about landing. So you have power lines or whatever they have in China. You have to worry about vehicle trafficking. You have to worry about every single thing. And you have to worry about not hitting it, not crashing, and a lot of things. And then you have to worry about rain. There you go. You know, if you just have, like, a piece of glass over you, I mean, the rain might not go where you are, but it might go right in front of you. The vehicle could malfunction. You could possibly die when the vehicle shuts off. Now, some people are saying, hey, it's waterproof. I mean, a lot of things, you know, are waterproof these days, known as cameras, phones, blue TVs, I know. I don't know if there's a waterproof TV out there. I know there is some things out there that are waterproof. Now, I mean, we're talking about this stuff. Now, they might have, well, they have like an a thing over you. Well, if it rains, boom, there you go. But you do have to worry about the wind speeds. Now, wind speeds crashing and a lot of things, you know, there could be a more, well, not really, but like it depends if this actually works. If this gets passed, I mean, we might, they might be flying, you know, safer, a lot of things, but like you have to worry about a lot of things doing that. If you want to fly somewhere, pretty much you would worry about wind speeds. I mean, if the wind speeds are really bad, then you can't go out. If there's a tornado coming towards you, there's nothing you can do. So if you don't own a car, you can call what, a taxi or something else. So there you go, guys. Tell me, am I wrong or am I right? Please let me know, and I'll see you guys later. Thank you very much, and I'll see you guys later.